Rule number one on Amisha's channel, bitch, don't come for me unless you do your fucking hair, because if your shit looks un-American, I'm going to fucking shade you, bitch. Bow.
What's up, YouTube? Amisha is finally back here with the 9-month update on HRT hormone therapy. Yes, for those who don't know, for the bitches in the back, let me wrap these lashes real quick. Boop, 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 boop. For the bitches in the back, I am openly transgender, definitely not hiding it. I'm so over people acting like because I look fish that I'm scared to at least let it be known. Like, get the fuck out of here. Anyways, let's get straight into the situation. I'm officially 9 months on hormones now, and I'm super, 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 super excited. But at the same time, I'm mutilated. Mutilated's not a good thing, obviously, because bitches are gonna be like, oh, what do you mean you're mutilated? Oh my god, you're mutilated. You're mutilated. Bitch, I be mutilated. The fuck? Like, I'm going through a whole transformation, bitch.
Give me space, bitch. Give me fucking space, bitch.
But for real though, let me get back to it. I'm officially 9 months on hormones. Thank you for everybody who is watching me. Thank you for all my Modutchin tribes out there, because you know you guys are my tribe. And I gotta shout you guys out there. Like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. First of all, make sure you also subscribe to my SoundCloud, soundcloud.com at Amisha Mode. You'll be able to find my tracks and my links. Boom, click, and I am working on new music. And I'm still trying to grow some motherfucking booty to fucking twerk that shit and work that shit. But anyways, I would like to let you guys know that I finally made it to 9 months on my hormone therapy. Once again, thank all of you guys out there who have saw me from day one trying to strive with this whole YouTube situation. I went from like literally picking up my cell phone and just recording to finally got my own setup going. I'm super uber happy about my setup, and now we can just jump straight into it. So now that I'm 9 months on hormones, I'm finally experiencing a lot of different things. In the beginning, it was more so like me getting my feet wet, getting used to being actually on the hormone therapy and getting my mental prepared before the body started to change. But now officially the body is starting to change and my mental is mutilated. For those who don't understand, I'm gonna just break it down. So let me get with the good shit first, okay? You know what I'm saying? Because everybody wanna hear the good shit. Oh yes, are you gonna look fish? Are you gonna look cute? You know, I am obviously 9 months in, boom, boom. Wouldn't trade it for the world. But there are days where the shit's not hot and people will not understand the situation that you're going through. Okay, so now that I'm 9 months into my hormone therapy, my skin is way different than what it used to be. I know I've been talking about that like in my previous channel, not my previous channels, dumb bitch. My previous videos about how my skin's getting softer and everything is starting to finally like move and shit like that. Like at that point, I feel like my skin was getting softer, but now I can honestly say like, my skin, everything now. Like, when I touch myself, I feel like a squish ball. Like
the stress balls that you grab, you know, you just wanna. Yes, honey. Yes, a bitch feels like a fucking stress ball. You gotta do a squeeze out. Squeeze, 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 squeeze out. Squeeze, 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 squeeze out. And she's ready.
My arms are finally like not as defined as they used to be. Remember I was telling you guys how I was feeling sticky ick body? That's what I call girl before hormones, you know, when your body's more manly and masculine. And I ran track and field, like I said before in one of my other videos. My body was way more defined as a guy. Not in a bad way, but more so in a way of like when you look at me, you can really like point the shit out. You know what I'm saying? Cause I ran track and my arms were kind of cut. You know, I always had a good little yeah, a good little body. I'm only 5'3", 120. But my skin is now different. I feel like it's more spongier. It takes to different vitamins and oils and different things like that that I put on my skin and makes it way flawless than I've ever thought. You know what I'm saying? Like, beforehand, I felt like my shit was A little masculine, a little hardcore.
A little hardcore, like, I make a grass and they'd be like, oh yeah, you is a man.
But now, skin is getting flawless every freaking day. For me also, another big change that I will honestly say besides the skin is my boobies. Dwing, dwing. Dween. Now you see these boobies? These are finally mine. I have no bra on under this sweatsuit outfit. Like, literally,
I'm free balling. I'm free balling. And I'm free boo 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 tittying.
This is how much I've started to grow. As you can obviously see, the shit's happening. I got like a mini fucking A cup. Like, I can literally grab my boobies. I'm super uber happy about that situation, because in the beginning, that was the first thing I was really in my head thinking that I wanted to happen the most. But little do you know, like, when you're growing your boobies, you go through so much pain and so much suffering that most girls on here that I've noticed, they don't really talk about the pain portion of being on hormones. And I feel like that's more important when you're doing your updates and stuff like that, because everyone's thinking of the image part. Like, yeah, as you see, from before, I'm getting fishier. Your testosterone's leaving. You're getting fishier. But you see that long butt? The fucking pain. These titties be feeling like death. And I'm not used to that part. They're growing at a rapid pace. Most girls, they grow like an A cup within about a good year. Sometimes some people just don't feel the estrogen, I guess, taking to their boobies or taking to their body, so they have to up their doses or up their type of brand of whatever estrogen they're using. For me, the estradiol has been very righteous. Since day one, I have been taking the same portion of estradiol and testosterone blocker, which is my spironolactone and my, you know, estradiol. I'm taking two a day for both of them, and I haven't went up or down in any of my medications, and I'm actually seeing results. Now, see, the difference for the girls that are out there trying to transition, I'm just letting you know right now, like literally right now, baby, everybody's body is going to do different things. So, because my body is doing what it's doing now, yours might not do the same thing. Everyone has their own side effects or whatever. You just got to take your pills and go with the wind's fabulous. And another thing about that, when you're taking your pills, I want to let girls know that the reason why I feel like my development is really growing and, you know, going with the wind's fabulous, is because I do it sublingually, if I said that shit right. You put your estrogen under your tongue and you let it melt and you get all the goodness. You know what I'm saying? It actually tastes like candy. And my spiral tastes like peppermint, to be totally honest. Like, so candies and peppermints is what I take. That's what I call them, you know.
My candy, peppermint, my candy, peppermint. Give me my titties and my booty.
But anyways, I'm sorry, you guys. I'm stuck on Little Pump. That's my millennial's husband. I love him so much. He's so fucking sexy to me. I don't care what nobody says. But I've only been taking the same dosage this whole time, 9 months in. I'm thinking about going up when I actually go into an appointment. I go into an appointment next week so I can actually catch up with my levels and see, like, where my testosterone and my estrogen levels are at. But, you know, the biggest thing I've seen so far, like I said, was my skin development going softer and my titties actually growing. My hips, I will honestly say, as you see this defineness, my visual that I have out there, I don't really show too much. The reason why I'm looking different from my visual was also because I recorded a whole 18 minutes of content and it just would not upload. So I guess I didn't do something right. I guess I feel like spirit guide, as you know. I'm a witch, bitch. Spirit guy was not letting me upload that last video. So I'm here to show off the body, to give it a little bit more in-depth as I can pull it down, you know, for educational purposes for the haters out there in the back. Boop, boop. In the back. Boop, boop, bitch, yes. As you see, my body is starting to really get its, you know, its definition. You see that side sway? See that side? Look at that body, bitch. Body. Look at that lower region. Sway and fucking cut. Booty. I feel like my 9-month booty shot type version was not giving me no justice at all, because whatever I'm wearing when I'm recording my videos, I feel like it's not showcasing my ass. But I got ass, so I'm just letting y'all hoes know. I really want to pull my pants down right now, because I have no shame in my game to let y'all bitches know. I got a little something back there, though. When I actually take these off, and the nigga really get to grabbing and whopping. But I got these sweats on, so let me not get my shit flagged out. But with the physical things, I feel like it's going great. Like, physically, I'm changing. Physically, I'm feeling it happen. But the pain physically is hard as fuck, because I feel like most girls don't understand when you're going into your, you know, transition, that you're not going to be the same person. You're not going to feel the same way. So let me not go off topic and stay on topic. The next difference that I've also seen a lot was literally, like, my T-zone area, I feel like it's more defined, like, my this here, too, my jawline and stuff. You know how, like, before I was really, really hardcore, I feel like it's finally softening up right up in here. Up in here, I'm starting to get a little pudgy-pudge-mudge. That pudgy-mudge-mudge. So I don't look like, Mr. Freeze man. Now, I ain't got time for that shit, because that's the shit that niggas really try to clock you for. But either way, they still be liking that shit. These niggas don't care if you're a nigga or not. As long as you got a whole day ready to, boom, everybody wanna be like me. Everybody wanna stick it in. Okay? No, for real, though. Y'all ladies need to watch out. But physically, I feel like everything is happening. But I feel like the most important thing I feel that needs to be talked about is not the physical shit. The physical shit is gonna obviously come every single month. Your body's gonna do different things, like I said before. You're gonna go through a lot of pain and a lot of suffering. The downside about me being my 9th month in hormones, I feel like I have no fucking energy at all. I feel zapped the fuck out. Before, with testosterone, I used to have all the energy in the world. I was able to pick up things and throw things and, you know, run fast and do whatever I needed to do, you know what I'm saying, to get the job done. Ever since I've been on 9 months, I feel like I literally have zapped the fuck out of energy and I don't feel shit no more. Like, it's hard to push random shit when I'm at work. Because when I'm at work, I do a lot of, like, I wouldn't say guy stuff, but I like to get dirty. I'm just saying, I'm pretty and I look high maintenance, but I like to get dirty. So, you know, I like to do the shit that the guys do sometimes. I like to get out there and, you know, work on my body and beast that shit. And I can't beast no more. Sad. Yeah. That's the only part about, like, being a guy I miss, having that extra strength. Now that I don't have that extra strength, it's really hard to, like, communicate with others and let them understand, like, yeah, my body's going through this transformation, but you have to understand, like, my body is not having the testosterone that it usually have to be able to pick up an extra person, to be able to drag an extra person.
I feel like I want to get him up with a bitch, even though, you know, I'm saying, I'll get him up with a hoe, but I don't feel that, boom, that power anymore. And I don't know how to, like, if I'm explaining it right to people, but to me, I feel like I've lost all my strength and everything, and I don't know if I have to regain that now that I'm getting more estrogen. But how I feel on the inside, I have no energy. I wake up in the morning, I'm dizzy as fuck. The morning sicknesses be crazy as fuck. Like, there's some mornings I wake up and I feel like I'm ready to get it, and boom, the whole world is spinning and I'm throwing up constantly. And not in a bad way of throw up, but a throw up like, you just know, you feel not sick, but a little off. Also, another negative side that I feel like I don't like about being on, you know, my 9th month is my menstrual cycles be popping in. Like, I finally now notice that when my body starts to do different things at different times within that week, it's that week. You know what I'm saying? I experience cramps all up in this region. I don't know if other girls do, but I've experienced the cramps. It hurts like shit. On top of that, if you're getting cramps with your boobies at the same fucking time and you're trying to do shit and you can't do, and you over here just, shuffling on out, your ass ain't gonna feel it. You know what I'm saying? Your attitude is not there. Your mental is definitely not there. I will honestly say, now that I'm 9 months in, the mental is fucking crazy. There's days where I can't even remember shit because I'm so fogged in the fucking head and trying to understand my own emotions beforehand. I wouldn't say as a guy, because I've always lived as a girl. So when I try to refer to myself as being a guy, which is not taking the medicine, that's how I'm gonna put it, you know? So
we can all understand each other. Hopefully I didn't fucking lose anybody. But before I started taking my medication, you know, the mental part came in really slow. And then all of a sudden, now I'm like 360. Like, I feel like I'm on the black side of the yin and yang now. At first I was good, now I'm fucked up. And it's not in a bad way. I don't want to scare anybody. It's more so in a way of your own thinking and the way you feel, the way you process your life, the way you process everything. Beforehand, I could look at things and brush it off and be like, Jay-Z, dirt off my fucking shoulders, fuck you, whatever, we can get him up. Now I'm a fucking crybaby. It's weird because I'm a strong individual. A lot of people say that I'm intimidating and that my presence is really, 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 really out there. Like, they can feel it. So now that I'm on estrogen, I feel like when I do have those, I want to call them the psychotic breaks. The psychotic breaks where I feel like I'm about to fucking explode because no one's either listening to me or no one understands me. Like, I want to fucking go crazy and really, like, choke the fuck out of a bitch and really mutilate a hoe out. Just do, do, do. Mutilate a hoe because they think that it's an image thing, and it's more than an image. It's like my mental too is fucking changing as long as my body is changing. Like, this shit's not just like a turn on turn off kind of situation. So I feel like mentally you're gonna go through those ups and downs that at a period of time where you felt like you didn't think about things or care about certain things, that all of a sudden, like, you know what I'm saying, it starts to really manifest and happen. I never wanted kids. I really don't like kids. But the crazy part is lately, I cry when I see newborns. Or I cry when I see the little toddlers come into my job and they're just so little. And just want my own little mini me. Like, oh, it breaks my freaking heart because I start to think about my life as if how it would be if I was a cisgender woman. I would already be married. I would already have a husband. I would already be in a successful career. But because I'm transgendered, I have to jump through all these hoops and all these obstacles. You know what I'm saying? That's just how I'm feeling now at this, once again, 9th month. Mentally, I feel like a woman now. I feel even more womanized. I feel like when I brush across myself, I can feel my titties. My mental, I can feel it. You know what I'm saying? It's really scary at certain points because you never think that you can make it to this level, but you really can. But you have to be willing to be that person to go through the fire in order to, you know what I'm saying, get that gold at the end. Because I'm not going to let nobody stop me from doing me. There's not been much of a gradual change from the 8th to the 9th month besides my mental going fucking bonkers, dunkers, unkers. Like, I feel like my 9th month for me has been more mental than physical. The physical part, I'm good on that. I don't know about the other bitches because I feel like when I've watched a lot of girls on YouTube, you know, no shade to none of the other queens out there letting you know, but I feel like they all give you guys the facade sway of it, the oh, it's cool. Oh, you know, I'm tired sometimes. Oh, I'm fish now today. Like, no, it's a lot of pain. If you're going to transition, I feel like you're going to go through a lot of pain. The power that you have before, you will not have it mentally or physically. You will be turning into a whole nother person. You have to be prepared to want to turn into that whole other person before you think about taking these pills, because these pills is really strong and they really do fucking work. You might not want them to, you know, work too fast or too slow. You want them probably to work the way you want them to work, but they work when the fuck they want to work. You know what I'm saying? You can be on that bitch for 5 months and not grow titties. I'm just saying. It just be that way for certain individuals. But for me, like I said, 9 months in, I'm mentally fucked. Like, and I'm not mentally fucked in a bad way. So don't get that shit twisted. It's more so in an emotional way. I feel more. I express more. I feel more womanly when I'm expressing something. If beforehand, if I didn't want to do something, I'll still do it. Now, I'd be like, I'm not. Well, I'm going to take the bitch. I'm going to be the bitch. I'll take the bitch role. It don't even matter because I'm not doing it. And a lot of cisgender people don't understand when you're going through a transition that it's really literally a transition. It's not something that is a game. I feel like mentally now I'm more upset with cisgender people because it's like they think they have it all wrapped together, like they understand this lifestyle, but at the same time you really don't. And when I'm trying to educate you and inform you on how I feel, even though it might not be the best way you think that you can articulate it, that you want to try to shoot a bitch down like you think you understand. Or like the cisgender women who be out there like, welcome to womanhood. Welcome to womanhood. Welcome to womanhood. Bitch, you've been in womanhood since 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, bitch. I'm literally 28 and I'm going through this shit on an everyday basis. And the difference is my estrogen is coming in artificially. Not naturally. Like, what the... Like, so there is going to be side effects. There is going to be certain things. There's days where I'm not going to feel good. There's days where I'm not going to be, you know what I'm saying, all the way in my 100. Because I'm going through my transition. And I feel like a lot of people, they understand trans people when they're looking at them. But they don't understand when you want to go onto a mental deeper level with understanding what they're going through on a daily basis. Yesterday was a good day for me. Today, I was 3 hours late to work because I couldn't wake up. I don't know how to explain that to other people. Like that energy of not having energy. Like the my soul battery is get the TLC going. You know what I'm saying? Because a bitch is done. Like I'd be wanting to flatline out. But I guess I just gotta wait till I get to a point where I'm leveled and everything's going great. I just want girls out there that are gonna transition. Don't transition for image. Don't transition because you want to look fish, because everyone's story is going to be different. But one thing I will say is when you're switching from testosterone to estrogen, your body is going to take a drastic hit. It doesn't matter what kind of field of work you're in or anything. You're going to take that gradual hit. You're going to take that mental change. You know, the first couple months is easy. But then once you start to feel that weight stick to you, when you start to feel your mental playing with you, when you start to feel that shit happening and you got to learn how to be a new person and navigate around it to not disrespect or hurt others and also not to feel like you're hurting yourself, you know what I'm saying? The shit's, it's not a game. And I feel like for every woman out there that wants to transition, and yes, I call them women before they want to transition, because if you know that that's what you are, no matter if they gonna tell you you going to hell and you mutilated, them bitches don't know what it is, and half them niggas anyway is down low and suck dick from the back and they eat the booter cat. Especially the straight ones who act straight, because most of the straight guys are gay, so I'm just gonna let that be out there, because the gay people that are gay, they're comfortable in their skin. There's way more gay people or way more other type of people that live these type of different lifestyles out there that just don't want to say it. And some of us just have the courage to go out there and live our open truth. And that's the shit that I do. I don't deal with nobody. And once again, boop, boop, do boop, 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 boop. I'm engaged. So for all the guys out there that think they want to crack jokes and be funny and act like, you know what I'm saying, like a bitch is chasing a nigga, I don't chase no nigga. You niggas come to me. Ever since I've been a tiny tot, niggas have been coming to me. And I'm just keeping that just 100%. Y'all don't know what you guys are. You don't know what the fuck you want. And in my 9th month, I finally understand after about to drop a, 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 baby, a with no time. Oh shit, I done pulled up my titty, damn. Baby, I done pulled out my titty. But 9 months pregnant without being pregnant, but being pregnant, I learned a lot. I don't trust these niggas. I don't give a fuck what none of you say. I don't give a damn how long you been with your man. I don't give a damn how long, how many times you ate your coochie, how many kids you got. Bitch, these niggas secretly like what it is. And that's here from Amisha's mouth. I'm just letting you know, ever since I've been a tiny tot, like I said, these niggas have been... And then to end off my video, I will honestly say the biggest thing is not my transition that I'm facing in my life. What I'm facing in my life now is being black. Being black and a black woman at that. Before I felt like it was me being trans. Now, a lot of racist shit, especially because I live in, like, the Seattle, Washington area, there's a lot of racist shit that be happening out here low-key. People just don't be peeping that shit. But if you live in those areas where it's like that, it be like that. And black is not in unless you're a black man and the, you know, the white Michelin man girls, you know, the Michelin man bitches with their little buns up there that be trying to act like they from the baddie wing, from the hood, you know what I'm saying? Them type of bitches, oh, I'm half black, but you look white type bitch. The Michelins, that's what I call them, because all the black guys seem to not get Barbie. They always get the
flat back ass 7-Eleven looking bitches.
And have the nerve to say you have standards and I need to know my standards. No, bitch, I know my standards. I need me a fine ass nigga. That's why I got a Dominicana and Puerto Rico. Back to it though, like I was saying before, my 9 months, I have realized a lot of shit from people, from myself, you know what I'm saying? And I'm just ready to give you guys all of my glory, everything that I have inside of me, and be able to coach other people into their transition and things like that. If you feel like you want to transition or anything or have any questions, you can always, you know, I would say DM me, but it's YouTube. So, you know, send me an email. I have my email down at the bottom of my page and stuff like that. So send me an email, you know what I'm saying? And ask me any questions. I'm an open book. I will honestly talk about anything. As you guys see, over time, my content will keep on growing. I'm growing even more. Like, as you see, blah, blah. Got my shit going finally now. I don't look like a weak-ass bitch on YouTube anymore with that cheap-ass, throat-ass shit. I can just be myself and express myself. I feel like my only way I can express myself is being on this camera and the light. And I can see, I feel like even though I'm in my setup, I can feel all the people who are watching me and who understand me. A lot of people who understand me from day one. People who went to school with me. Like I said, I've been transitioning for damn near way beyond 10 to 15 years plus. I'm just now taking my hormones. So don't get it twisted, bitch. I've been a bad bitch. I just, you know, wanted to get my titties. And now I'm getting extra. You know what I'm saying? But I would like to thank all my supporters out there. My page and my channel will be growing over time. So make sure you guys keep up with all my latest videos. Make sure you ring and subscribe to my page. Ring the little buzzer, dozer, dozer. I'm sorry I'm a little bit like in the mouth because I did drink a lot of wine. I just got off work, so I drank me some wine and tried to relax myself and record this 9 month because the last one I did, Spirit Guide didn't want it to release. So I think this gives you more of my personality and more of who I am. I am very, very, very cutthroat. And I am very, 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 very uncensored at times. I can be a censored bitch. Don't get it twisted. But I feel like with this YouTube channel, I want to have it as my own personal diary. This is where I come and spill out my emotions, where I come and spill out all my tea. This is where I come and spill other bitches' tea that want to come for me, especially you guys out there. If I hear any hate comments and shit down there at the bottom of my sway, you will be shamed. I'm just letting it be known. Like, all that other shit, especially the Bible thumpers and all, I don't got time for none of that shit. I've been graduated from that step in life. And you guys need to focus on who you are and what you want in life. And who you are in life. Because I know who I am in life. And that's Amisha. You see that long pause? You see that face of stone cold steel? Baby, I know who I am. Y'all need to know who you are before you get to talking some shit and trying to run somebody's shit. But I thank everybody out there who has been following me, like I said, and this is going to be the end of my 9th month update. I don't think I need to talk about anything else. You know, I got at least some of the stuff out that I needed to say, but until next time for my 10th month update and my 10th month visual, make sure you guys like and subscribe my shit. On top of that, like I said before, I will be having other content on my page. I'm going to have all my tarot stuff soon coming up, all my music stuff soon coming up. There's going to be all my dance videos, so it won't just be limited to my HRT and my Life of Amisha show, because my Life of Amisha show shows all my fashion shit with Fashion District Northwest that I actually work with. I am a model coordinator. So I got significance up in this bitch, okay? So don't, I'm just not no sideshow bob ass bitch. I'm just saying, from within the crevins of the sanctums of the with wretch of the embellishments, honey. That's more to the T later on when I explain to you guys my actual language for the people who probably don't understand my language. But I love you guys, and thank you guys for staying tuned to my channel. And I'll be back with more content, because this is your girl, Misha Mode, and I am here to stay. Ew. Kanye dressed me up like a doll, then I hit